Women's groups in Kenya are calling for long overdue action to tackle rampant gender-based violence in the East African country after the death of another athlete at the hands of her partner. Rebecca Cheptegei lost her fight for life in the early hours of today, 4 days after her boyfriend poured petrol over her and set her ablaze at her home in Western Kenya. The 33-year-old Ugandan long-distance runner, who had recently competed at the Paris Olympics and was a mother of two lovely daughters, was the third female athlete to be killed in Kenya since 2021.
This is the fourth murder in a series of murders from 2021 for female athletes. But this is also another, I will not call it murder, I will call it femicide, because femicide is the intentional murdering of women due to their gender, and also intimate femicide, which is what happened in this case.
Statistics in the number of victims of gender-based violence in Kenya vary widely, which campaigners say mask the true scale of the problem. In 2022, Kenya recorded 725 women dying in gender-related killings, the highest since 2015, according to data collected by the UN Office on Drugs and Crime. Femicide Count Kenya, which pulls data from local media, said 152 women were killed in 2023.
If you look at it, there is a thread of finances, the fact that these women have been able to be on the prime of their life, been able to amass wealth, and this wealth unfortunately has led to their death.
The killing of Cheptegei follows the murder of two high-profile Kenyan athletes. In October 2021, a record-breaking Kenyan runner, Agnes Jirop, 25, was stabbed to death at home in the Rift Valley. Her estranged husband is on trial over her murder and has denied the charges. In April 2022, Kenyan-born Baranian athlete Damaris Mutua was also found dead in Eton in a suspected domestic violence incident. President Yoweri Museveni has said he will support the police in constructing a crime data analysis center that will help the Criminal Investigations Directorate carry out investigations efficiently. Museveni was speaking during the annual coordination meeting between the Office of the DPP and the Criminal Investigations Directorate at Chibuli under the theme, "The Contribution of ODPP/CID in the Socio-Economic Transformation of Uganda." The CID Director, AIGP Tom Magambo, had asked Museveni to support their efforts to construct the facility at Chibuli.
When I insisted on introducing the cameras on the roads, you have seen how much the cameras have helped you if you are working properly.
The president told police investigators and other public servants whose salaries were not increased to be patient, saying that the country is handling the issue in a prioritized way.
One way of doing it is the Nyankore proverb, which says, "Okom Toguri, Eshudunkui Tengwa." The hairstyle depends on the shape of the head. If you have got a big head, then the hairstyle will go accordingly.
The chairperson of the Electoral Commission, Justice Simon Byabakama, asked the criminal investigators to actualize electoral laws by prosecuting those who commit electoral offenses.
Under the Parliamentary and the Presidential Elections Act, civil servants or public servants are barred or banned from engaging in campaigns. You are not allowed to support a particular candidate.
He cited public servants who use government resources during elections, as well as leaders who incite violence among the youth. The two-day annual coordination meeting was attended by over 620 participants, comprising of investigators, prosecutors, and key stakeholders who discussed and aligned their efforts towards a common goal. The Minister for Kampala Capital City Authority and Metropolitan Affairs, Hajat Minsa Kabanda, had said that reports claiming 28 people are still missing and unaccounted for from the collapse of the Chitezi landfill are mere speculation, because the official report from the Office of the Prime Minister indicates only 11 persons are still missing. Kabanda made the remarks while appearing before Parliament's Committee of COSASE, where she had accompanied top management of KCCA to respond to queries raised in the December 2023 Auditor General's report on waste management by the authority.
But following the rescue exercise, 18 people were rescued from the rubble, while the number of those who died were about 35 people, according to a task force report. 11 people are still missing.
The landfill collapse, which engulfed at least 35 homes, has led to the deaths of 35 people, with 18 others rescued. However, discrepancies in reported figures has raised questions among MPs. Nedad Segona, MP for Busiro East, challenged the government's inconsistent numbers. He cited reports from a local official that 28 individuals were missing, yet the minister maintained the official count was 11.
The deputy RDC informed us that 28 people were missing. And by that time, they had retrieved 35 bodies. Now you're telling us of 11 missing. Have you retrieved more bodies that have not been recorded?
KCCA Executive Director Dorothy Chisaka acknowledged that the landfill's near capacity state and the challenges posed by insufficient funding for its maintenance. The landfill, located in Chitezi, has faced scrutiny for mismanagement, with the Auditor General's report warning that it poses a significant health and environmental risk.